Hey YouTube, how's it going? Kiefer DeLorme here with Clientric. And in today's tutorial, we will be continuing our multifaceted series on the Zoho CRM. Last two sessions, we went through leads and contacts, and today we'll be going through accounts. But I figured now would be a good time to explain what the difference is between each of the tabs for anybody that doesn't already know. So you can see, so contacts is what we went through in the last session. So contacts refer to people in an organization that you communicate with in pursuit of a business opportunity. And so today we'll be going through accounts, which refers to the company or department within a company that you plan on having business dealings with. On lead conversion, the lead's company name will be converted to the account name. So going back in, so we went through leads. And then last time we went through contacts and we created Jimmy. And today we'll be going through accounts. So in the account section, it will look very similar to the leads and contacts sections. You'll be able to filter a million different times based on exactly what you're looking for. And you can see the Pepsi account was created. So let's go in there. And you can see all the company information here. So first we have the account owner, which in this case is me, user one demo. Industry, let's say, what would be a good one for Pepsi? Large enterprise. How many employees? Let's edit. Click the edit button. And here's where we can edit everything. So we'll go through. You can create an account number here. Let's create 1234. Account type. This would be a customer in this case. Industry, we'll say large enterprise. Annual revenue, we'll say $1 million. Just for now, obviously Pepsi makes more than $1 million a year. And employees, we'll say they have 100. Address, we'll go 123 Sunshine Street in Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. And the shipping will be the same thing. And you can see description information here. I think it's always a good idea to put description information in for anything. That way, whenever you're referencing the file, you can get a quick overview of the company. So let's say Pepsi is a large enterprise specializing in soft drink manufacturing and shipping logistics. And from there, you have the description set up, and so you can click save. And then again, we have our overview and our timeline. So you can see all the information that we just changed showed up in the history, and you can see where John and Jimmy Smith were created in our previous sessions. So going back over here, we'll go through the related list. So taking a look at notes, here's some notes that were made in the past. So the client was reached out to via Twitter. That was what we said in the last session with Jimmy Smith. And previously before that, John was mentioned that they're currently using Zoho One and would like more information on integrating LawPay. So that was a note that I had made at a previous time. So any attachments you can create here. So you can upload file straight from your computer on documents, Zoho Work Drive, Zoho Docs, or any other cloud drive. So that includes basically Google Drive, iCloud, anything like that. So you can also create deals, contacts, any open activities you have with the customer. So that again includes any tasks, meetings, or phone calls. Any closed activities will go through past activities that you've had with the customer that have now closed. Emails, again, you can go through, create a new email, and you can see any emails that have been sent out relating to this account. So you can see one has been sent out to John and one has been sent out to Jimmy. And you can click on them and actually see the information. And you can actually print them as well, which is kind of neat. So if you need to print any information from emails, you have that option. And from there, you can add any products that they have. So let's go through that there. You can add a senior consultant. So let's do that. Add to account. And from here, you can do any quotes, sales orders, invoices, any cases you can assign or create a new one, or any information that's already existing will show up here from elsewhere in your Zoho CRM. Their social media accounts will show up here. So any Facebook or Twitter, you can have that information included there as well. Any Zoho projects, which we will be going over at a later date, you can create a new project, associate an existing project, or any active projects will show up in here. Any extension related information will be here. So here's Ring Central SMS, Twilio SMS. Zoho Desk is for ticket generation and workflows. You can create those or see any existing ones here. And then your existing contacts that are related to this account will show up here. And that is it in terms of the account section. Thank you for watching today's video. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave us a comment. If you like the video, you can like or subscribe. And other than that, I hope you have a great week. And remember to stay awesome. Thank you very much.